Little kids, we've all heard this saying, this phrase, when we were being brought up. All play and no work makes Jack a dull boy. And at the same time, people like me, who have been brought up in Urdu-speaking families, have also heard this phrase said about by my mother or by my father, that "Pad likh kar main ek din Sikandar banunga, aur agar nahi padhunga, to main ek din Bandar banunga." Now, these two phrases, the first one is actually said on the occasion when you want to actually take a break from studies and work and stuff. And the second one is actually said when the parents want to bring your focus back to studies. Little kids, when we are school going kids. Now, both are the extremes, the two extremes. One, trying to focus on work and leisure activities, and the other one, trying to focus more on studies. But the beauty or the essence of both of these is in creating a balance, in creating an equilibrium between the two things. Like, if you are studying, you should be studying at a particular time, and then you should also take regular breaks to indulge in those activities that actually groom you for other things. Now, I'll take you to a trip down the memory lane back when I used to be a kid, and at that time, like probably around 10 or so years back, at that time the cell phone was the main thing. Like, it had just come and it was like the new thing in the market. So most of my friends used to have cell phones. I got a cell phone when I came to grade 10 or 11. So that was a time when my grades used to, you know, they started to decline and I was starting to lose focus. Now, at that time I decided that in order to be able to continue performing in my studies as I should have been, I will need to limit myself. I will need to create a balance in my life with regard to that particular little gadget that has entered my life and taken over. So what I used to do was, I used to target myself. I used to give myself targets that if I will be able to do this or this portion of studies today, then that means that I've achieved my target, and then I can use or play or use that cell phone for that particular amount of time. So this helped me in grooming myself, in starting to bring my focus back towards study. Now, that was one thing. To explain this concept of creating a balance and equilibrium in our lives, I will use a little equation from chemistry. Now, this is an equation which is used in chemical equilibrium in chemistry. A plus B reacting to give you C plus D. Now, A and B are reactants and C and D are products. And this arrow basically shows that this reaction is reversible. It can go either ways. So now, at any one point in time, this system exists in equilibrium. There is an equal amount of reactants available and an equal amount of products available at a particular time. However, if you increase the quantity of A or B, for example, the reactants, they will start reacting more and the product's quantity will also increase until the time the equilibrium is established again. Same goes if you have more of the product, the reaction will go in the backward direction. However, this equation or this reaction is governed by some external factors as well. I'll just take two for example. For example, there is one that is high temperature, and then there's another one, high pressure. High temperature favors the forward reaction and high pressure favors the backward reaction. Now, let's come to our lives and take what I mean from this equation. Let's take two categories. There's one is working or studying or doing that sort of thing. That whole is clubbed into one side. And then there's another one that is leisure or sports or doing something that enjoyment. That is another thing. So these two are the two sides of the equation. Now, if I talk about conditions, let's take good weather, availability of friends as a condition that will favor the forward reaction. That it will favor you to go towards enjoyment. That if you are actually working, there's good weather, your friends are available, they make up a plan, you would be inclined to go towards the enjoyment side, towards maybe going out, maybe having to go out for dinner or to play something. However, if there's condition of, let's suppose, for example, or if there's a financial constraint, then you would be more inclined towards your work or your studies. So this is how basically an equation governs your life. And in order to create that peace or that tranquility, you need to establish a balance between the two. You need to learn or you need to understand when to focus on what. And if I talk about in terms of our religion as well, there's an incident that happened in the life of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. He was actually with Hazrat Abu Bakr and Hazrat Umar. And he was talking to Hazrat Abu Bakr and he was saying that, "Abu Bakr, I passed by you and you were praying in a very low voice. Hazrat Abu Bakr replied, O Messenger of Allah, I was having an intimate conversation with the one whom I was praying to. And then Holy Prophet talked to Umar. Umar, I passed by you once and you were praying very loudly. And Umar replied that, O Messenger of Allah, that was because I was waking up the drowsy and driving off the evil. On listening to both of them, Holy Prophet just told them that Abu Bakr, you should work on raising your voice a little, and Umar, you should focus on lowering your voice a little. Now, that was Holy Prophet's way of guiding his companions. Now, it's a simple thing, you know, voice, speaking or talking. But even in that, our religion tells us follow the middle way. The way which is not too high, not too low, but in the middle. And even in Quran, Allah says, Allah labels us as Ummatan Wasata. Wasata. Wasata means the middle. That we Muslims are the community of the middle way. They follow the middle way, the middle path, the path of Adl, Insaf, justice. These are all derived from this thing that we are the Ummah of Wasat, the middle Ummah. Now, this doesn't mean that we are compromising on certain aspects, but this does mean that in whatever we do, we need to follow that middle path, neither of the two extremes.